in the military are on the rise. 26,000 cases last year alone, and now Congress is taking the historic step of threatening to overhaul the military justice system. Action News reporter Hallie Jackson lays out all the options.
In a rare session in front of senators, the Joint Chiefs together agreed change has to come from the top. The question is, how?
And I looked at victims in the eyes whose system, the system had failed them.
Navy veteran Taryn Meeks watched as the country's top military leaders appeared together on Capitol Hill.
Combating sexual assault and sexual harassment within our ranks is our number one priority.
I have five sisters. I have a mother. They set my moral compass on this issue.
The Joint Chiefs acknowledge sexual assault has become like a cancer, a stain following years of war.
Frankly, I think we probably, I'll speak for myself, I think I took my eye off the ball a bit.
A Pentagon report showed thousands of sexual misconduct cases may have gone unreported last year. Now, lawmakers in the Senate Armed Services Committee are considering seven bills, including one to strip commanders of the ability to decide which sex assault cases go to trial.
Not all commanders are objective. Not every single commander necessarily wants women in the force. Not every single commander believes what a sexual assault is.
But that's a big point of contention for the military.
It's absolutely the wrong direction to go.
Having that ability to refer a case to court-martial is crucial, not only to the commander's credibility, but we also speak of trust in this matter as well.
They don't want to take any of this authority away from the commanders.
They're misinformed. I really think that they are frightened of the military justice system as we know it changing at all.
More than 3,000 sexual assaults were reported in the military last year, and Senator Claire McCaskill says if changes to the military's culture are successful, that number will go up as more victims feel more comfortable coming forward. In Washington, I'm Hallie Jackson, Channel 4 Action News.